Hey agents, and welcome to another daily episode of Target Loot. Today, your daily farming guide for Tuesday, January 19th. In this series, we cover a lot: the Target Loot map, Darkstone exclusives, highlights for the weekly vendor resets, which just reset today, and of course, build and farming suggestions as well. This is Shadow Gaming, and if you're new to the channel and enjoy this video, consider pressing the thumbs up and subscribe buttons below, and if you didn't, a thumbs down. And remember to hit those bell notification icons to all so you never miss another daily morning video. And comment below if you have any questions or feedback whatsoever. Otherwise, let's get this video started. Alright guys, so starting off with the Dark Zones and of course Vendor Reset Highlights, which are always in that big bottom left overlay that pops up right now. What I would highly recommend picking up this week is in DZ West. We got that Rock and Roll Shotgun with Perfectly Extra for 152 DZ resources, and then there's a Force Multiplier backpack with Perfect Combined Arms. It's actually at the White House, and it's got skill haste and skill damage, so this is exactly the way you want it rolled. It's just a little low at about 60%, but you can always optimize it, or otherwise you could farm it on EU targeted loot. For DZ West, we got Murakami today, so of course you can farm for those Emperor's Guard knee pads with 1% armor regen. Those mix wonderful with the Foundry Bulwark set to make you basically invincible in any tank build, so definitely farm for those today if you need to get those for your build. Now over here in DZ South today, we got another great thing to farm for: pistol targeted loot. We got two Darkstone exclusive pistols today, the TDI Card Custom that gives you an extra skill tier, and then the Orbit Pistol with Perfect Finisher, which a lot of people might not know is a really, really good weapon, and that finisher talent is amazing. All you gotta do is finish that enemy off with your pistol, then swap to your, you know, Dark Winter or whatever you're using, and it gives you a ton of damage, which will be in the bottom left overlay. And then lastly in DZ East, we got Marksman Rifle, so of course you can farm for the Pinprick with Perfect First Blood. Now of course, I never really used that, and it used to be really good for PvP, I don't really know anymore, but that is what you can farm for in the Dark Zones today. And of course that includes all the exotics that go with MMRs and pistols, technically the Liberty and all that good stuff. So now let's move on to the North Side, agents. Alright agents, so starting off with the North Side targeted loot highlights and the invaded missions this week, we got Jefferson Plaza and then Space Administration HQ, Capitol Building Stronghold, Tidal Basin, and of course Lincoln Memorial. Over here in Camp White Oak, we got Providence Defense today if you want to farm for that sacrifice with Perfect Glass Cannon, amplifying all damage you deal by 30%. But also amplifying all damage you get by 60%. It, you know, makes you extremely squishy, but is wonderful in all DPS and skill damage builds. Next up, we got chests over here at Coney Island Ballpark. Two exotics, you got the Tardigrade and Ridgeway's Pride. Tardigrade is a True Suns faction exotic, which you could just straight up farm for. The Ridgeway's Pride, you need to, you know, complete the project you collect from the summit first, otherwise have a teammate share. Always let your teammates know what you're farming for too, by the way. Tip of the Spear, I never really recommend. And then we got holsters at Manning National Zoo, three exotics, the Waveform, and then of course Dodge City Holster and Imperial Dynasty. The Waveform you unlocked at season level 4, level 90. The other two you could just straight up farm for. The Dodge City, you'll find exotic components when farming holster targeted loot, so no worries there. And then you could also farm for the Forge Holster, which gives you 50% extra shield health, which is equivalent to an extra skill tier worth of shield health. And then actually, Kinley College is open for another 6 days and 14 hours as of this recording, and the summit you pick your own target to loot. Now let's move on to the West and East Sides. Alright agents, starting off with the West Sides with the gear sets, we got Strikers over here at Potomac Event Center. I always recommend just using 3 pieces. 4 pieces, never, it just doesn't deal enough damage, especially with accuracy being an average of maybe 70%, and that's on PC. It never just compares to an all high-end build, so 3 pieces for like a Merciless build or an LMG build or something like that. Next up in Downtown West, we got Negotiator's Dilemma. Now of course I'll put my favorite double LMG build in the top right title card now. That's 4 pieces of Negotiator's Dilemma and the Coyote's Mask. And you could run the Contractor's Gloves if you're running it with the Pestilence or Bullet King, or you could run the Grupo Sombro Gloves and run it with an AR or SMG, and then I always run that with the Pestilence or Bullet King though. That's just my favorite way of running a DPS crowd control build. As for Hardwired, I think that it's a dead gear set and they should get rid of it. Rigor is much better, and you could farm that at the White House for instant cooldowns and skill damage, but I don't have a build suggestion yet for you guys just yet, sorry about that. And last but not least, my favorite gear set, West Potomac Park, Hunter's Fury. I'll put my favorite build in the top right card now for Hunter's Fury. And that's going to be four pieces of Hunter's Fury, the Death Grip Gloves, and the Memento Backpack. And of course, I run the Dark Winter and the Scorpio on that one with three armor cores and four weapon cores. Or you can run a Soak Glove Chest with Intimidate or my favorite, Obliterate. And that deals more damage, and I still roll three armor cores on it. For the rest of targeted loot, we got Haunted U at the Pentagon if you want to farm the Force Multiplier Backpack with Perfect Combined Arms. If you don't think that one at the White House is good enough, then definitely farm it today at the Pentagon. This mission's actually kind of fun. And then we got Mass over here at Lincoln Memorial. Fast mission to run. I can get it done in 8 minutes with that Hunter's Fury build I just talked about with the Death Grip Gloves and the Soak Glove Chest. The two exotics being Coyote's Mask and Vile Mask. Coyote's is wonderful for you and your allies for DPS, giving you crit hit chance and crit hit damage. And then of course the Vile Mask for status effects and skill damage with that debuff, and use the Demolitionist spec to increase the Vile debuff. Next up, we got Gloves targeted loot at Roosevelt Island. Now of course it's a manhunt mission, which I forgot to tell you guys today, the manhunts reset, so that's awesome. Can't wait to do that. But what you can farm for today here is the BTSU Data Gloves, which grants overcharge to you or any ally that's at skill tier 6 by canceling or destroying your hive. And then of course you could also farm for the Contractor's Gloves with 80% damage to armor, which is great for any LMG build or stacking damage to armor. But I highly prefer you farm Petrov if it's available on today's map. The last couple we got is Walker Harris Akoa Constitutional Hall. Now of course you could farm for the Chainkiller chest piece with Perfect Headhunter. I never ever go without this on a headshot damage build, and I always roll it with weapon damage, weapon handling, and headshot damage. And really, that's all I'm going to recommend for the west side. Let's go check out now what we got on the east side. Alright, agents, east side targeted loot highlights. Starting off with the gear sets, we only got a couple. I'll mention Eclipse Protocol, my favorite fire damage build in the top title card now. That's four pieces of Eclipse Protocol in the Imperial Dynasty holster. And then put on one piece of Golan gear for an extra 10% status effects, and run that with the Stinger Hive and Firestarter Kim Launcher. Next up, we got Ongoing Directive at American History Museum. I got two great bleed damage builds for you. The first one, though, you're going to need Ridgeway's Pride. Four pieces of Ongoing Directive. And then, of course, you want to run the Anarchist Cookbook with Perfect Wicked, since the Eclipse Protocol backpack does not work all by itself anymore with its bonus talent system aggravator. And you always want to run the Scorpio and the Carnage with Perfect Sadist on these builds, by the way, with bleed damage builds. Next up, for the builds, I would recommend four pieces Ongoing Directive, Badger Tough Backpack with Creeping Death Talon, and then of course the Vile Mask. And then lastly, we got Aces and Eights at Space Administration. Three pieces of Aces and Eights, two pieces of Aralda Holding, one being a backpack. You could put Composure or Vigilance on one of them. And then run the Chainkiller chest piece with Perfect Headhunter. And my primary MMR I recommend is the Mantis. And the secondary would be like an Ekim's Longstick with Perfect Ranger. That is 20 million a headshot, easy. For normal targeted loot, we got Empress at Jefferson Plaza. I'll put my favorite skill damage build, turret drone build, in the top title card now. Now, that's going to be three pieces of Empress, two pieces Haunted U, and the Waveform Holster, running Kinetic Momentum on the chest piece, and the Force Multiplier Backpack with Perfect Combined Arms, the Capacitor, and the Harmony Rifle. Next up, we got Golan Gear at Capitol Building Stronghold. You could farm for that Anarchist Cookbook with Perfect Wicked that we mentioned for the Ongoing Directive Bleed Damage build. Definitely worth it. It's really the only best alternative to the Eclipse Protocol backpack that got fixed in Title Update 12. So definitely check that out today at Capitol Building Stronghold. And oh yay, we got rifles again in targeted loot. We haven't had this in a few days, or at least the past day. So for rifles, you got two exotics, the Merciless and the Diamondback, both of which I never really recommend personally. But I do recommend the two named ones that drop outside of the Dark Zone, which is of course the Surge with Perfect Spike and the Baker's Dozen with Perfect Lucky Shot. Both of those are great. Next up, some machine guns at Federal Triangle. Three exotics, Lady Death, Chatterbox, and the Backfire. The Chatterbox is the only quest exotic submachine gun. Now, I'll put a video in the top right card now that shows you in 5.5 minutes how to actually get that, and it's actually faster than farming SMG targeted loot. Otherwise, I would farm for the named SMGs like the Safety Distance with Perfect Outsider and the Grudge with Perfect Vindictive. Those do drop outside of the Dark Zone, unlike the Dark Winter in the Apartment, which do only drop from NPCs in the Dark Zone, or if you're lucky enough to get it from a named item cache or a manhunt target. Last couple we got is Assault Rifles at Jefferson Trade Center. Now the Eagle Bearer is one of the exotic assault rifles, but it's still tied to the Dark Hours raid, so you still got two others you could farm for. that being the Chameleon with Adaptive Instincts and the Capacitor with Capacitance, but the Capacitor you need to complete 5 summit challenges first before it joins the general AR targeted loot pool. You could actually just do that on like story mode or normal, because exotics don't scale with difficulty on their rolls, and get that done in like an hour or less. Otherwise, there's a bunch of named ARs in the bottom left overlay I highly recommend. Definitely the burnout named Famas, the mechanical animal, and the test subject. I really like those in particular. Last couple is Douglas and Harding at Downtown East. You can farm that punch drunk mask with 20% headshot damage baked into it. And there's actually one over here at the campus this week. Sorry, that's the theater. The campus over here. So if you want to try and pick that up, you can definitely do that. You're just going to have to reroll the third attribute slot, and the weapon damage is at about 11%, I think. And then knee pads at Grand Washington Hotel. Of course, you got a couple of exotic knee pads, Ninja Bike Messenger, and then Sawyers. They're completely opposite. Sawyers, you just stand still to gain the 30% weapon damage, you know, 1% by 1%. And then Ninja Bike Messenger, you can get instant reloads, and then, of course, bonus armor by doing cover-to-cover or vaulting. And then, of course, you can farm the Fox's Prayer knee pads with 8% damage to targets out of cover, which is definitely worth farming for. I highly recommend farming Overlord for it, but I don't see it anywhere on the map. But if it is in New York City, I would farm that for sure. And speaking of New York City, let's go check it out now. Alright, agents, last but not least, we're here at New York City Targeted Loot Highlights, starting off with gear sets. True Patriot always seems to be in New York lately. So at 2 bridges, I'll put my favorite SMG build in the top right card now with True Patriot. That's 4 pieces of True Patriot, the Sokolov chest with Intimidate, and the Memento backpack, and I always run Lady Death or the Scorpio with it. And that's great for solo, 4-man groups, heroic, and legendary. Over here, here's Overlord at Civic Center for the Fox's Prayer, and then Contractor's Gloves for the Tombs at Petrov. And then, of course, we got Future Initiative at Pathway Park. Now, remember, the chest and backpack are raid exclusive to the Iron Horse raid on normal mode. So in lieu of that, I always run an Alp Summit chest piece with Empathetic Resolve and a backpack with Safeguard. And that's actually better or just as good as the chest and backpack of Future Initiative. And then last but not least, we got shotguns at Battery Park. So of course you can get 2 exotics, Sweet Dreams with the Sandman Talon and the Scorpio with Septic Shock. The Scorpio you are rewarded at season level 55 for season 4 rewards. And then you can farm it shotgun targeted loot. So remember that. And it's probably the best shotgun in the entire game. Now of course the other 4 best shotguns I recommend would be the Rock and Roll Shotgun with Perfectly Extra, which you can pick up in the DZ West vendor this week, and then of course the MOP with 10% armor on kill, and the Custom Inmate 70 and the Marine Super 90, and I always roll close and personal as the Talon on those. And really, I didn't want to skip this one, but Badger Tough at Liberty Island, you could farm that 0F's chest piece with Perfect Unbreakable, great for any DPS hybrid build. Just throw something like Vigilance on the backpack so you got some damage as well as survivability. Well, agents, that's it for your daily farming guide today. I hope you enjoyed the video, and if you did, consider pressing those subscribe, like, and share buttons below, and if not, a thumbs down. If you'd like to become a member for extra support and exclusive perks, you can click the join button below, and thank you and shout out to all of my channel members. And always remember to check the video description and pinned comment below for links for everything. Useful info for you guys, supporting my channel, like the Shadow Gaming merch store, and you know, joining, Discord, clan, everything is down there. Anyway, take care, agents, and be sure to stay tuned for more daily Division 2 content. This is Agent Shadow signing off. I will see you in the next video. Take care, agents.